He's really in the mother, so he's just an equal four hydrophones, and that's very well suited for exciting the central background. And if you have five equal phony cockpits, the single model action is back on the quadratic, so it's trivial to quantize. You have a canonical momentum for P, a canonical momentum for theta, which I'm calling P, but it's a fermionic variable, and these are just the n equals 2 b equals 4 theta. So you have to take theta eight up, and you also have the left moving and the right moving one, a theta half eight, a theta half eight up. And then you have a action for the Colombian vector, which is the hydrophones will decouple from this four-dimensional vector. Okay, so it's convenient to do a Cayley representation for the n equals 2 d equals 4 supersymmetry, in which the Cayley supersymmetry generator is each theta and each theta half. Once you do that, then these, of course, are abelian supersymmetries because the square of things is zero, which means we can now t-dualize like the theta a and theta half a. So we're not going to break the t-dx part of theta. Now, in order to t-dualize, we need some non-vanishing value for d11. Now, that can be changed by adding a trivial surface term. So if capital C is constant, this is, of course, a total derivative for the same reason I just mentioned. So you can add a dependent on these being more surface terms to add more symmetry. So in this case, I'm going to choose d, h, d. So a and d, remember, are just, they go just a chiral two-component index. So this is, c is symmetric, then just a self-quotient. So this is the term I'm going to add. And after t-dualization, it's easy to see that what you get an extra coupling of t, t, half. So you just proceed to simply do the same motion procedure as before. You add this, with on multiply, you integrate out the Wilson gauge field, and you find this extra term to generate. So this term, precisely the term you add, if you want to describe the self-fluographical fun graph back on in the hyperspondism, where you add, where FAB is just the self-fluographical fun field check, so it's proportional to the inverse of and this, of course, was used in topological things, and also puts aside the non-intercommutative gauge theory by Horiyabak and Horiyabak and also by Cypress. Now, as I mentioned earlier, this fermionic T-dualizer is a valid symmetry for genus 0 amplitudes, but the higher genus surfaces, these two backgrounds are not equivalent, and the reason is because of the extra fermionic variable, which I mentioned, it has to be added. So at least for three amplitudes, flat backgrounds and self-fluographical fun backgrounds are very similar, but for loop amplitudes, they're extra features. Okay, now let me go to the case which is most interesting, which is the stadium side of the side backbone. So you can decide if you can signal model, so the side side is constructed in current, so this is just a reach full signal model. You construct these less invariant currents constructed out of this G taking value to the ADS by the side post at PS 64, vessel 4, and vessel 5. Now you can look for capital A, either be a vector index, or a left moving or right moving spinner index, so like n equals 2 spinner index. And then you just write down the reach full signal model in terms of these less invariant currents. You have to follow the simple form. This comes from GMN, this comes from BMN. And this is D11 is non-vanishing, so you don't have to add any non-trivial surface terms. This actually, of course, is variant by the global PS624 isotropy, which comes from acting on the left by this constant matrix PS624. And now, if you choose a graph,
we'll be starting the next part, but I'm going to start that one.
not be against 5.65 background, and you choose to de-equalize the T4X in these cases, you end up with the same background. Okay, so let me put the application now. So these are applications which have already been found. So it explains the dual superconformal symmetry for perturbative decaying those amplitudes, which will be described in the next part. It can also be used to relate non-local conserved currents of the ADS-5.65 signal model with these dual superconformal generators. So you have these dual superconformal generators that I discussed, which are not in the original ones, and they cannot be related to these non-local conserved currents. So this was described by Dedot in two papers. And exactly the same as well as spatial polarization dependence, this extends the algorithm on the center as well. Well, it explains the angle density of the middle line correlation function and arbitrary twist couple. So let me just quickly take a possible future application. So, of course, one possible application is to use this program to equalize to learn about the self-geographical plane background. Another possible application is to use some similar invariants of other ADS background, ADS 3.3, for example. One more speculative application is to try to use from line to enlarge the usual algorithm group of supergravity background. So, this, of course, is usually taken to be some of line group, which involves T duality and the next duality. Now you have a new type of fermionic duality, so that may align this group to supergroup. Of course, this is only for changes zero amplitude, but still this may be useful. And one possible application is in these E10 or E11 models, which have been discussed by very possible questions, mainly Nikolai and collaborative and Western collaborative. These E10 or E11 models, they can actually extend to some supergroup models if you include fermionic duality. And it might be a more natural way than what has been done until now for these models for understanding the fermionic supergravity field. So there's a very nice way to understand the bosonic supergravity field as being related to the bosonic root lattice of these models, and maybe if you have fermionic generators, you can similarly understand the fermionic supergravity field.
Any questions?
Series and ask the fourth term with a coefficient which is a function of the moduli, and that coefficient encodes